Hello students, in today's lecture video we shall discuss about the detailed estimate of septic tank and soak pit for 50 users. I am Soumya Sahu, lecturer in civil engineering at SKTP Common Polytechnic Raulkela, and this video lecture is prepared for the 5th semester diploma civil engineering students. So before we go into the detailed estimate of septic tank and soak pit, first I will share a video describing the three-dimensional view of a septic tank and soak pit. After having a clarity on the three-dimensional construction sequence of septic tank, then we will move to the detailed estimate part of septic tank. First, we must understand what is a septic tank. A septic tank is an underground chamber made of concrete, fiberglass or plastic through which the domestic wastewater flows for basic treatment.
Hello friends, main Neeraj Sharma swagat karta hu aapka civil house design mein. Agar aap is channel pe naye hain to channel ko jo subscribe kijiye. ये वीडियो सेप्टिक टैंक डिजाइन का फर्स्ट पार्ट है जिसमें हम जानेंगे कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक एंड सोक पिट और साथ साथ इनके वर्किंग प्रोसेस। ये एक इमेज है जिसमें सेप्टिक टैंक दिख रहा है। इस सेप्टिक टैंक में ये है हमारा इनलेट पाइप और ये है आउटलेट पाइप और ये है वेंट पाइप। वेंट पाइप में यानी कि जो गंध होती है सेप्टिक टैंक से निकलती हुई वो बाहर जाने के लिए होता है। और ये दो मेन होल्स हैं यानी कि इसमें दो चैम्बर होंगे। ये बैक साइड से सेप्टिक टैंक। आगे बात करते हैं, ये टॉप व्यू है। टॉप व्यू में ये दो मेन होल्स दिख रहे हैं और ये वेंट पाइप है। आगे बात करते हैं कि इसका कंस्ट्रक्शन कैसे होता है। इसके कंस्ट्रक्शन में सबसे पहले बात करते हैं ये जो स्लैब है, टॉप की स्लैब और बॉटम स्लैब। तो ये टॉप स्लैब है, इस स्लैब में दो मेन होल्स दिए जाते हैं और ये बॉटम स्लैब है। बॉटम स्लैब का क्या है, इसमें स्लोप दिया जाता है, जो स्लोप होता है बीच में बैफल वॉल की तरफ। ये दिख रहा है यहाँ पर मिड में ये बैफल वॉल है। इस बैफल वॉल में मिड पर होल दिया जाता है ताकि यहाँ से वेस्ट वाटर सेकेंड चैम्बर में ट्रांसफ़र हो सके। और साथ साथ ये दिख रहा है इनलेट पाइप और ये दिख रहा है आउटलेट पाइप और ये टॉप स्लैब जिसमें दो चैम्बर मेन होल्स हैं इस दोनों अलग अलग चैम्बर के लिए। आगे बात करते हैं, ये दो चैम्बर्स हैं और जो ये सेप्टिक टैंक होता है इसको बनाया किससे जाता है, ब्रिकवर्क से बनाया जाता है और साथ साथ इसमें प्लास्टर किया जाता है। तो प्लास्टर करते समय हमें ध्यान देने वाली बात यह है कि अगर आप सोक पिट बना रहे हैं तो प्लास्टर करते समय कच्चा प्लास्टर से कीजिए ताकि जो वेस्ट वाटर है वो सीपेज हो जाए, ग्राउंड वाटर ग्राउंड में चले जाए। लेकिन अगर आप सोक पिट भी बना रहे हैं तो इस प्लास्टर को अच्छी तरह से किया जाता है। इसमें इम्परमेबल मटेरियल का यूज़ किया जाता है ताकि वेस्ट वाटर सीपेज ना हो सके और आउटलेट से सोक पिट में चला जाए। और साथ साथ जो ये चैम्बर है इसका साइज होता है 2 फीट बाय 2 फीट का। अब बात करते हैं मिनिमम साइज ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक। मिनिमम साइज में सेप्टिक टैंक की जो चौड़ाई होती है वो 2 फीट 6 इंच और जो हाइट होती है वो लिक्विड की हाइट होती है 3 फीट 4 इंच यानी कि लिक्विड हाइट। और ऊपर जो ये हमारा एम्प्टी एरिया होता है, इस एम्प्टी एरिया को हम फ्री बोर्ड बोलते हैं। इसका जो हाइट होती है वो 20 से 30 सेंटीमीटर तक दी जा सकती है। तो ये इसका लिक्विड का हाइट हो गया। और वॉल्यूम के अकॉर्डिंग जो मिनिमम वॉल्यूम का जो दिया जाता है सेप्टिक टैंक के लिए वो 1 मीटर क्यूब का होता है, यानी कि इसका जो वॉल्यूम होता है मिनिमम वो 1 मीटर क्यूब दिया ही जाना होता है। अब इसकी लंबाई की बात करें तो इसकी जो लंबाई होती है वो इसकी चौड़ाई का 2 से 4 गुना होता है। और तो ये सेप्टिक टैंक आगे की ओर आउटलेट से सोक पिट से कनेक्ट किया जाता है। अब सोक पिट की बात करते हैं तो ये हमारा सोक पिट है। इस सोक पिट में जो वॉल होता है वो ब्रिक वर्क से बनाया जाता है और इस ब्रिक वर्क जो बनाया जाता है वो हनी कम ब्रिक वर्क होता है, यानी कि ब्रिक वर्क के बीच बीच में होल छोड़ दिया जाता है ताकि जो वेस्ट वाटर है उसका सीपेज हो सके। और आगे ये हमारा आउटलेट पाइप है जो इस सोक पिट के मिड में आता है और ये चैम्बर है हमारा। इस चैम्बर को भरने के लिए हम पोरस मटेरियल का यूज़ करते हैं और बहुत ही कॉमन है कि इस पोरस मटेरियल के रूप में हम ब्रिक के टुकड़ों का यूज़ करते हैं। तो इस तरह से सोक पिट का कंस्ट्रक्शन करते हैं। अब प्रोसेस क्या होता है कि यहाँ से हमारा वेस्ट मटेरियल एंट्री करता है फर्स्ट चैम्बर में और जो इसमें ठोस मटेरियल होता है वो नीचे की ओर बैठ जाता है और कम ठोस मटेरियल ये बैफल वॉल के मिड में जो होल होता है उसमें से सेकेंड चैम्बर में एंटर करता है। सेकेंड चैम्बर में भी इसमें जो ठोस मटेरियल होता है वो नीचे की ओर बैठ जाता है और ऊपर की ओर पूरा वेस्ट वाटर आ जाता है और ये वेस्ट वाटर यहाँ से हमारा आउटलेट्स होता हुआ सोक पिट में एंटर करता है। सोक पिट जो होता है वो वेस्ट वाटर को एब्जॉर्ब करने के लिए होता है, तो इसलिए ये पूरे वेस्ट वाटर को खुद में एब्जॉर्ब कर लेता है, और एब्जॉर्ब करता हुआ जो वेस्ट वाटर होता है वो नीचे की ओर ग्राउंड में चला जाता है, और ग्राउंड होता हुआ प्योरीफाई होता होकर ग्राउंड वाटर में चला जाता है। इस वीडियो में इतना ही, आगे की वीडियो में बात करेंगे कि सोक पिट और ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स के बीच के डिस्टेंस कितना रखा जाता है, और साथ साथ साइज ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक के बारे में भी बात करेंगे। तो मिलते हैं अगले वीडियो में। थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मैं नीरज शर्मा स्वागत करता हूँ आपका सिविल हाउस डिज़ाइन में। अगर आप इस चैनल पर नए हैं तो चैनल को जरूर सब्सक्राइब कीजिए। ये वीडियो सेप्टिक टैंक डिज़ाइन सीरीज का सेकेंड पार्ट है। इस वीडियो में हम जानेंगे डिस्टेंस बिटवीन सोक पिट एंड ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स, यानी कि जो हमारा सोक पिट होता है और ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स होता है उसके बीच में डिस्टेंस कितना रखना है। तो ये जो डिस्टेंस होती है वो पूरी तरह से डिपेंड करती है हमारा सोक पिट और ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल के बीच के डिस्टेंस पर। यानी कि अगर ये डिस्टेंस जो सोक पिट और ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल के बीच का डिस्टेंस है वो ज़्यादा होगा तो हम जो हमारा जो ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स है उसे हम सोक पिट के पास ही रख सकते हैं। लेकिन अगर ये डिस्टेंस कम होगा, यानी कि जो हमारा ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल है वो काफ़ी ऊपर ही आ जाता है, तो हमें ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स को अधिक दूरी पर रखना पड़ेगा सोक पिट से। तो ये डिस्टेंस कैसे दिया जाता है? अगर सोक पिट और ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल के बीच का डिस्टेंस 6 फीट 7 इंच यानी कि 2 मीटर से ज़्यादा है, यानी कि ज़्यादा डिस्टेंस है, जब ज़्यादा डिस्टेंस है तो हम उसको पास में ही रख सकते हैं, यानी कि तो हम ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स को सोक पिट से मिनिमम 9 फीट 11 इंच यानी कि 3 मीटर तक के डिस्टेंस पर रख सकते हैं। और अगर सोक पिट और ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल के बीच का डिस्टेंस जो है वो 6 फीट 7 इंच से कम है, यानी कि 2 मीटर से कम है, यानी कम होने का मतलब क्या हो गया कि ये बहुत ही पास में, तो इससे क्या होगा कि ये जो सोक पिट का वेस्ट वाटर है वो उससे ये ग्राउंड वाटर पॉल्यूटेड हो जाएगा। तो हमें क्या करना है, अब ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स को इससे अधिक दूरी पर रखना है। तो ये दूरी क्या होती है हमारी, मिनिमम डिस्टेंस होता है 33 फीट यानी कि 10 मीटर। तो जब हमारा जो ग्राउंड वाटर टेबल है वो सोक पिट से 6 फीट 7 इंच से कम डिस्टेंस पर होगा तो हम ड्रिंकिंग वाटर सोर्स को सोक पिट से मिनिमम 33 फीट के डिस्टेंस पर रखेंगे। तो इससे क्या होगा कि हमारा जो ड्रिंकिंग वाटर है वो पॉल्यूटेड नहीं आएगा और स्वच्छ रहेगा, इससे सबकी हेल्थ अच्छी रहेगी। तो इसलिए ये बात खास ध्यान देने वाली है कि जब भी सोक पिट बनाए तो हम ड्रिंकिंग वाटर को कितने डिस्टेंस पर रख रहे हैं, इस चीज़ का हमेशा ध्यान रखा जाता है। तो उम्मीद करता हूँ ये वीडियो आपको पसंद आया होगा। ये सेकेंड पार्ट है, अगर आपने फर्स्ट पार्ट और थर्ड पार्ट नहीं देखा है तो उसे भी देखिए। बाकी मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में। थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग।
नाउ आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी हैविंग अ क्लियर आइडिया रिगार्डिंग द 3-dimensional कंस्ट्रक्शन सीक्वेंस ऑफ सेप्टिक टैंक। स्टूडेंट्स, look at the plan and sectional elevation displayed on your screen. Here you can see the plan of the latrine, the plan of septic tank and the plan of soak pit, and above the plan you can see the sectional elevation of latrine, septic tank and soak pit. This is the pipe joining the latrine to the septic tank which is having a length of 3 meters. And this is the connecting pipe, which is the stoneware pipe connecting the septic tank to the soak pit. Here you can see the 2 chambers of septic tank. This is the cover of the manhole and this is cover of the another manhole. In the longitudinal section, here you can see the standing wall separating the 2 chambers. This line represents the water level. This is the stoneware T pipe and again this is the stoneware pipe and this pipe is connecting the septic tank to the soak pit. This is the soak pit. The soak pit is made up of honeycomb wall. This is the picture of a honeycomb wall. Honeycomb walls are provided so that the wastewater can easily be absorbed by the soak pit. And in the cross section of soak pit you can see it is filled with 60 cm JAMA brick ballast and 1.8 meter JAMA brick pad. The JAMA bricks are nothing but the overburnt bricks. They are only used for making aggregates for lime concrete foundation and as road material in road construction. See the cross section of latrine. Here you can see the flushing cistern. Here you can see the cowl is provided. I have shared a slide showing the picture of cowl. So cowls are generally provided to prevent the backflow. In the cross section, you can also see the anti-siphonage pipe, the cast iron pipe, and here beep cocks are also provided. Here I have shared a slide showing the beep cock, and this is known as the stop cock, and this is the picture of a brass ferrule. So with this background knowledge, now we will go into the detailed estimate of septic tank and soak pit for 50 users. Students, in the examination, you won't get a question to describe all the items of a septic tank in detail, but you will get questions for the detailed estimate of some of the items. Like they will ask you, mention the detailed estimate of the following items like earthworking excavation, cement concrete work, first class brickwork. They will mention it. They won't ask you the entire estimate of septic tank and soak pit. The first item is earthwork in excavation. So the excavation work is to be done for the septic tank and soak pit. So the number of septic tank is 1 and the soak pit is also 1. So as you can see the plan, the length of the septic tank for which the excavation work is to be done is 4.7 meter from this point to this point. And the breadth for which excavation work is to be done for septic tank is 1.9 meter. From this point to this point. And the depth of excavation for septic tank is from this point to this point. So this total depth will be 67.5 centimeter plus 50 centimeter plus 40 centimeter plus 15 centimeter, which is equals to 172.5 centimeter or 1.725 meter. So the length, breadth and depth are mentioned here for the excavation work of septic tank and the quantity is calculated as 15.41 cubic meter. If you see the plan of soak pit, you can see this diameter is 1.5 meter. This breadth is 20 centimeter and here also it is 20 centimeter. So the total diameter of the soak pit for which the excavation work is to be done is 1.5 plus 0.2 plus 0.2, which is equals to 1.9 meter. So the area will be pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4 into 1.9 square. And the depth for which the excavation work is to be done for the soak pit is 3 meter from this point to this point. So first the area is calculated pi by 4 d square, pi by 4 1.9 square. Multiplied with the depth, which is 3 meter. So the quantity is calculated as 8.5 cubic meter. And the total quantity for the excavation work is 23.91 cubic meter. The next item is cement concrete work in foundation of septic tank. So the length of the cement concrete work of septic tank will be 4.7 meter and the breadth will be 1.9 meter. And the height of cement concrete work of septic tank will be 0.15 meter from this point to this point. And the number will be 1. So 1 multiplied with 4.7 multiplied with 1.9 multiplied with 0.15, which is equals to 1.34 cubic meter. The next item is the first class brickwork in 1:4 cement mortar in septic tank. So first we will consider the long walls. This is the first footing. This is the second footing. And this is the third footing. So the first footing is having breadth of 40 centimeter and the second footing is having a breadth of 30 centimeter and the third footing is having a breadth of 20 centimeter. The height of the first footing is 40 centimeter, the height of the second footing is 50 centimeter and the height of the third footing is 67.5 centimeter. For long walls, the length of the first footing is from this point to this point. So this total length is 4.5 meter as we have to deduct the projection which is having 10 centimeter on either side. Here it is 10 centimeter and here also it is 10 centimeter. So 4.7 minus 0.1 minus 0.1, which is equals to 4.5 meter. The length of the second footing will be from this point to this point. So this length will be 4.5 minus this projection and this projection. So 4.5 minus 0.1 minus 0.1, which is equals to 4.5 3 meter, and the length of the third footing will be from this point to this point. So this length will be 4.3 meter minus the projection of 10 centimeter on either side. So 4.3 minus 0.1 minus 0.1, which is equals to 4.1 meter. So the length of the third footing will be from this point to this point, which is equals to 4.1 meter. And the number will be 2. For the first footing, the number is 2. Length is 4.5, width is 0.4 meter, and the height is 0.4 meter, and the quantity is calculated as 2 into 4.5 into 0.4 into 0.4, which is equals to 1.44 cubic meter. For second footing, the number is 2. Length is 4.3 meter, width is 0.3 meter, and the height is 0.5 meter. So the quantity is calculated as 1.29 cubic meter. For the third footing, the number is 2. The length is 4.1 meter, width is 0.2 meter, and the height is 0.675 meter. And the quantity is calculated as 1.11 cubic meter. Then we will see the salt walls. So the number of salt walls are 2. And the length of the salt wall is 0.9 meter from this point to this point. So for the first footing, the number is 2, the length is 0.9 meter, the width is 0.4 meter, and the height is 0.4 meter, and the quantity is calculated as 0.29 cubic meter. For second footing, the number is 2, the length is 0.9 meter, the width is 0.3 meter, and the height is 0.5 meter, and the quantity is calculated as 0.27 cubic meter. For third footing, the number is 2, the length is 0.9 meter, the width is 0.2 meter, and the height is 0.675 meter, and the quantity is calculated as 0.24 cubic meter. And the total quantity involved in the first class brickwork is 4.64 cubic meter. Then the next item is the reinforced brickwork in partition wall with 1:3 cement mortar in septic tank, including the reinforcement complete work. So as you can see the longitudinal section here, you can see the reinforced brick work in the partition wall. The length is 0.9 meter. In the plan, it is very clearly mentioned that this partition wall is having a length of 0.9 meter. Height is from this point to this point. So the height will be 1.2 meter plus this height is 0.15 meter. So 1.2 plus 0.15, which is equals to 1.35 meter, and its breadth is 10 centimeter. It is mentioned here 10 centimeter RB standing wall. So its breadth is 10 centimeter, and the number is 1. So the number is 1, length is 0.9 meter, breadth is 0.1 meter, and the height is 1.35 meter. So the quantity is calculated as 0.122 cubic meter. The next item is the RCC work in septic tank and soak pit, including the reinforcement complete work. So, first we will see the slab cover of septic tank. From this point to this point, this is the total length of the slab cover of septic tank. So, from this point to this point, this length is 3.7 meter, and you can see this slab is inserted into the brickwork. So this projection is 10 centimeter, and on this side this projection is also 10 centimeter. So the total length of the slab cover will be 3.7 plus 0.1 plus 0.1, which is equals to 3.9 meter. And the breadth of the slab cover will be from this point to this point. So 90 centimeter plus the 10 centimeter projection on either side. So it will be 0.9 plus 0.1 plus 0.1, which is equals to 1.1 meter. And its height is 0.075 meter. It is mentioned here 7.5 centimeter RCC. So its height will be 0.075 meter. So the number will be 1. Length will be 3.9 meter, breadth will be 1.1 meter and the height will be 0.075 meter. So the quantity will be 0.322 cubic meter. Slab cover of soak pit. So here in the sectional elevation you can see the slab cover of soak pit and it is also inserted into the brickwork. So from this point to this point this length is 1.5 meter. And this projection is 10 centimeter on both the sides. So the total diameter of the slab cover of soak pit will be 1.5 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 which is equals to 1.7 meter. So we can calculate this area by using the formula pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4, 1.7 square will be the area of the slab cover of soak pit and its height is 0.075 meter. It is mentioned here 7.5 centimeter RCC cover. So the height will be 0.075 meter. The area is calculated as pi by 4 d square and it is multiplied with the height 0.075 meter and the number is 1 and the quantity is calculated as 0.17 cubic meter. The next one is the support of pipe in soak pit. In this picture you can see the support for pipe and its length is from this point to this point. As you can see, it is somehow inserted into the brickwork. So this projection is of 10 centimeter on both the sides. So the total length of the support pipe will be 1.5 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 which is equals to 1.7 meter and its breadth is 15 centimeter or 0.15 meter and its height is 6 centimeter or 0.06 meter. So the number is 1, length is 1.7 meter, breadth is 0.15 meter and the height is 0.06 meter. And the quantity is 0.015 cubic meter. And the total quantity involved in the RCC work in septic tank and soak pit is 0.507 cubic meter. The next item is 12 millimeter plastering inside the septic tank with 1:2 cement mortar mixed with waterproofing compound. So first we will see the long walls. So the plastering work will be done from this point to this point and this length is 3.7 meter. And the height of the plastering is from this portion to this point. So this entire height is 1.5 meter. How? See, this point to this height is 1.2 meter and above which this height is 30 centimeter. So 1.2 plus 0.3 is equals to 1.5 meter. And the number of long walls are 2. So number is 2, length is 3.7 meter and the height is 1.5 meter. So the quantity for plastering work is 11.1 square meter. Then for sot walls, the number of sot walls are 2. And the length of sot wall is 90 centimeter or 0.9 meter and its height is from this point to this point. So this entire height is 1.5 meter. So the number is 2, length is 0.9 meter and the height is 1.5 meter. So the quantity is calculated as 2.7 square meter. Then next the plastering work is done in the partition wall. Both sides. So as you can see, this is the partition wall and on both the sides the plastering work is done. So the length of the partition wall is from this point to this point. So the length is 90 centimeter and the height of the partition wall is from this point to this point. So 1.2 plus 0.15 meter, which is equals to 1.35 meter. So the number is 2, the length is 0.9 meter and the height is 1.35 meter. So the quantity is calculated as 2 into 0.9 into 1.35, which is equals to 2.43 square meter. The next plastering work is done on the top of the partition wall. On the top portion of the partition wall, the plastering work is done. So the length is 0.9 meter and the width of the partition wall is 10 centimeter. It is mentioned here, 10 centimeter. So the number is 1 because the plastering work is done on the top of the wall and the length is 0.9 meter and the width is 0.1 meter and the quantity is 0.09 square meter. So the total quantity involved in plastering work is 16.32 square meter. The next work is the cement concrete floor. So the length of the cement concrete floor is 3.7 meter and its breadth is 0.9 meter. So the number is 1. Length is 3.7 meter and the breadth is 0.9 meter. So the quantity is 3.33 square meter. The next item is the second class brick work in 1:6 cement mortar in soak pit. So in soak pit, honeycomb wall is provided. This is the picture of honeycomb wall. Here we have to take the mean circumference. So the mean diameter is 1.5 plus 1.9 divided by 2, which is equals to 1.7 meter. So the mean circumference will be pi into mean diameter. So pi into 1.7 and the breadth is 0.2 meter and the height is 3 meter. The quantity is obtained by multiplying pi into 1.7 into 0.2 into 3 meter, which is equals to 3.2 cubic meter. The next item is the Jama brick ballast of 10 millimeter size inside the soak pit. The overburnt brick are known as the Jama bricks. So it is provided for an area of pi by 4 d square, where the diameter is 1.5 meter. So the area will be pi by 4 into 1.5 square. And it is provided for a height of 60 centimeter. So the total quantity will be pi by 4 d square into 0.6, which is equals to 1.06 cubic meter. Then in the lower portion, again the Jama brick beds are provided. So the area will be pi by 4 into d square. So pi by 4 into 1.5 square. And the height is 1.8 meter. So the height is 1.8 meter. So if we multiply pi by 4 into 1.5 square into 1.8 is equals to 3.18 cubic meter. Then the next item is the cast iron manhole cover of 45 centimeter diameter over the septic tank. So there are two number of manhole covers provided here, 1 and 2. So the number is mentioned here. So two numbers of manhole covers are provided. Then iron footsteps are provided in the septic tank. So if you look at the cross sectional elevation, here you can see the iron footsteps over here. So 8 number of footsteps are provided. So it is mentioned 8 numbers. The next item is the sanitary work. So water closet Indian pattern of 50 centimeter white glazed pan with siphon is to be provided. So as you can see, the section of the latrine, you can see only one set of Indian type water closet is provided with the flushing system. So it is mentioned that one set of water closet is provided. Then the next item is the stoneware pipe of 100 millimeter diameter. So the first stoneware pipe is the pipe that is connecting the latrine to the septic tank, and the second one is the pipe which is connecting the septic tank to soak pit. So if you see the figure here, you can see this is the stoneware pipe, and this pipe is connecting the latrine to the soak pit, and this is another stoneware pipe, and this is connecting the septic tank to the soak pit. And both of the pipe has got length of 3 meter. Here it is 3 meter, and here it is also 3 meter of length. So it is mentioned here that the connecting latrine stoneware pipe to the septic tank, the number is 1, the length is 3 meter. So the quantity is 3 meter, and the stoneware pipe connecting the septic tank with the soak pit, the number is 1, the length is 3 meter. So the total quantity is 3 meter. And the total length of the stoneware pipe is 3 plus 3, which is equals to 6 meter. The next item is the stoneware T-pipes of 100 millimeter diameter at the inlet and outlet of the septic tank. So see, this is the inlet of septic tank, and this is the outlet of septic tank. And here you can see two number of T-pipes. So it is mentioned two numbers of stoneware T-pipes. So the next item is the cast iron heavy soil pipe of 100 millimeter diameter connecting the latrine vent pipe including fixing with lead jointing. So this is the cast iron pipe, and this length is 5 meter. So 5 meter of cast iron heavy soil pipe is provided. The next item is the cast iron heavy soil pipe of 50 millimeter diameter complete. So the first one is the pipe connecting the latrine pan with the vent pipe. Its length is 60 centimeter or 0.6 meter. So the number is 1 and the length is 0.6 meter. The next cast iron heavy soil pipe of 50 millimeter diameter connects the vent pipe for septic tank, and its length is 3 meter. So the number is 1 and the length is 3 meter. So the quantity is 3 meter. And the total quantity of cast iron heavy soil pipe of 50 millimeter diameter is 3 plus 0.6 is equal to 3.6 meter. The next item is the cast iron cowl of 100 millimeter diameter in latrine. Here you can see in the latrine, it is the cowl provided. This is the picture of cowl. So the number is 1. And the next item is the cast iron cowl of 50 millimeter diameter provided in the septic tank. In the longitudinal section of septic tank, you can see here, this is the cowl provided of 50 millimeter diameter. So the number is 1. The next item is the 250 liter GI tank. So over here, only one tank is provided. So the number is 1. The next item is the 15 millimeter diameter GI pipe. The first GI pipe connects the GI tank with the water main. So its total length is here 2.8 plus 0.6 plus 1 meter plus 10. Plus 0.6 meter extra pipe is provided. So the total length of the pipe is 15 meter. Next, the GI pipe connects the cistern from GI tank. So the number is 1 and the length is 2 meter. Next, the GI pipe connects the water tap from the GI tank. The number is 1 and its length is 4.5 meter. So the total length of the GI pipe is 21.50 meter. The next item is the 15 millimeter diameter brass stopcock. So two number of stopcocks are provided. This is the picture of stopcock. The next item is the 15 millimeter diameter brass beepcock. So one number of beepcock is provided. This is the picture of beepcock. But this is not a brass beepcock. This is a steel beepcock. Beepcock is nothing but your normal tap, water tap. So in your estimate, brass beepcock is provided. Then the last item is the brass ferrule. One number of brass ferrule is provided. So this is the picture of brass ferrule. So with this, we have completed the detailed estimate of septic tank and soak pit for 50 users. The PDF files will be shared with you in your official WhatsApp group. So go through this video lecture. And if you have got any doubts, you can ask me in the official WhatsApp group. Thank you, students.